Namaste children. Till now, what we have seen in the motion and measurement, we have learned the definition of motion and rest and how they are related. And we discussed about the measurement, what is meant by standard measurement and what is meant by unit, what is meant by magnitude and how can you measure the lens. What are the approximate measurements, that is the body parts, and how can, what are the devices used for measuring the length. Now here these are the different methods. Suppose if your scale is broken, what is the correct method of measuring? This is called as incorrect method, because from 0 to 1 is 1. So this is the correct method. And how can you observe the measurement? How the eye should be there? It should be always parallel to your measurement. If it is from sides, the measurement will be wrong. This is the wrong position of eye. This is the correct position of eye. If like this, if you are measuring, that is called as parallax experimental errors. So this is how to measure the length by using a scale. Next, coming to, these are the standard units of measurement. Why? Because we are measuring with the scale and these are fixed units which are accepted by the whole world. Approximates of unit of length. Units of length, this is hand span, palm, digit, cubit, pace, foot span and arm span. This we have discussed. These are all approximate. Now going to the next part of the chapter, that is types of motion. Now any object according to physics moving with respect to its position, that is surroundings, and with respect to time is called as motion, and rest is with respect to time and surroundings. If the position of the object is not changing, we will term it as rest. And these two are relative. How? I told, suppose you are sitting and moving in a car, with respect to the seat you are at rest, but with respect to the time and surroundings outside you are in motion, but actually the car is in motion, along with the car you are moving. Types of motion. There are different types of motion. One is random motion, translatory motion, rotational motion, oscillatory motion. Now in translatory motion are rectilinear, curvilinear, circular motion. These are included in translatory motion. And rotational motion is different. And oscillatory motion, in oscillatory motion, two oscillations as well as vibratory also will be present. Then here random motion. Random motion is the path cannot be described, zigzag. Now pictorial form of this is, see what is random motion. Usually the ant, butterflies, is random motion. So motion have no specific particular path. In translatory motion, motion in which all the particles of a moving body can be described and they are same, identical, all the particles can be, you can describe. This is inclusive motion, you can say. Translatory motion is not single, it is inclusive motion. For example, in this car is moving, it is moving on a straight road. So the object car is going in a straight line path. So it is called as linear. Linear or rectilinear, but when you consider the wheel will be in circle, it is moving, but when you go in circular motion, how about an axis? So this is inclusive motion. Translatory motion is inclusive motion. Now if the in the translatory motion, if the object is moving in a straight line path, it is called as linear motion. Usually we will be talking about rectilinear, about the energy. If the energy is moving in a straight path, the wave is passing in a straight path, for example, light energy goes in straight line, that is rectilinear. Now curvilinear is also one more type of motion which is included in the translation. If the path of the moving object is in curve, taking a curve, that is curvilinear. Now circular, if the path of the object is in circle, then it is called as circular motion. For example, moon going around the earth, or earth moving around the sun. This is circular. We will be telling it as in social studies revolution. Then next is rotational. What is rotational? See, rotational motion also includes two. For example, if you consider the fan, the blades of the fan will move in circular path, whereas if you see the head of this, it will be, these will be rotating in about an axis. So this is paving circular path, but this is at about a fixed point, these are moving in the circular path, that is at a fixed axis. This is called as rotational. Same way, all the planets and satellites also rotate, rotatory motion they will exhibit, rotate about their axes. For more example, your playing blade also in the rotational. Now coming to oscillatory motion, the to and fro motion of any object from its rest position is known as oscillatory. In the oscillatory motion, the whole body will be moving, that is to and fro. Coming for front is to, going back is fro. From the rest position, exactly middle position, that is rest position or reference position, or you can say mean position. So example is motion of a swing. It will go in oscillatory motion. There is a small difference between oscillatory and vibratory. Vibratory motion is only the particle will set, whole object won't move, the particles of the object will be set into to and fro motion. For example, beating of a drum. Now some more examples here. Rectilinear motion, the man is running in a straight line path, rectilinear or linear path. Then circular motion, the hands of the clock are in circular. Rotational, the disc is moving your car discs about an axis, that is rotational. Now here pendulum is in oscillatory motion in this watch, whereas periodic motion means if the object is moving, if for example the hands of the clock will be going equal distances in equal intervals of time they are covering, that is periodic motion. So vibratory motion is periodic. The marching of the soldiers on the bridge, that is why rhythmic it will be, that is periodic. At equal intervals of time this oscillation will take place. Now coming to the examples, see, this is one more example of rectilinear motion, pushing a box in linear path. Marching of the soldiers are marched past by the students in a straight path, this is also linear. Now apple falling in the downward direction, vertical but a straight line, so this is also one more example of rectilinear motion. Now coming to the circular motion, here you can take this is as earth or sun, the planets moving around, this is revolutionary we'll say, or path is circular, so circular motion. Then this is called as uniform circular motion. Why? Because at every point it will be moving in the circular path, but the direction of the speed in every path, suppose if you are taking this is the point, you will be drawing it at this motion, line speed will be changing, but the object will be going in circular path. This is in terms of social, we will say revolutionary motion. The planets will undergo revolutionary and rotatory motion. When the planets are moving, sun and planets, example, earth and moon, one more circular, electrons will be moving around the atom, in nucleus of the atom in circular path, and this is the circular tracks they will be giving for the events, that is running and all. Then even for the cars also, circular track, then such giant wheel. These are all examples of circular motion. But in this, see, this giant wheel move around one axis also. It is all the spokes will be at one axis, they will be rotating. This is called as axis, axis of rotation. When axis of rotation is there, the path of the object moving is in circle. These are together, integrated, like together. One, not singly it can't be. These will be same way the wheel of the car, same way the earth around the sun, same way the moon around the earth. This is about the axis. Now this boy also going in the circular path, his axis will be shown. This is the axis exactly at the center of the ground. So this is called as giant wheel. These are examples of circular motion. Now coming to rotatory motion is nothing but the spinning motion of objects is called as rotatory motion. Spinning means this is going in the circular path, keeping the axis at the center. So along with the axis won't move in any path, just it will be in that place only, in and it will be rotating. So your blade, I don't know exactly, the rim of the blade will be in the circle path, but exactly at the center it will be in the rotatory spinning, rotatory motion. So for example, wheel of the car at the axis, steering wheel will be having axis, but when you are rotating it, what this is the axis, this will be spinning. Steering wheel and blade and spin top, this and giant wheel, these are all examples. One of the examples, even earth, moon, whichever is going circular path will maintain the rotatory motion also. And your car wheels, these are the examples. Now coming to rotating a fan, see the blades will be in the circular path, exactly in the middle will be, this is the in rotatory motion, this is the called as axis. To maintain circular motion, the object must undergo even rotation also, that is about one axis it will be going. So it is rotatory motion. This will be under rotation. Same way here, these are all the spikes are in the rotatory motion. Then your spinning wheel, spinning top, these are all, even hands of the clock, these are all in the rotatory as well as revolutionary motion. Now coming to periodic motion, already if the motion is repeating exactly at equal intervals of time, and the same thing is repeating, marching of soldiers on the bridge, that is rhythmic, reproducible motion at every fixed interval of time is known as periodic motion. So revolution of the planets is periodic, example, periodic motion. One more, marching of soldiers in day-to-day life, even revolution of planets also periodic motion. And all the mechanical devices on the earth can be designed to have periodic motion. So these are devices which are useful for the timers. Those are called as oscillators. So those who will be designing in the mechanical devices, usually for example gear wheels, we'll say those are all called as oscillators. So these are under periodic motion. Now see, this is periodic. Then vibratory motion, when you are striking the string of this, the particles, object totally, the string won't move from the guitar or violin. Same way the membrane won't come out of the drums, because only the particles will be set into the vibration, so that sound will be observed. If you want to see, you put a small paper on the in V shape, you make and put it on the membrane of this drum, or on the after striking the on the guitar, then it will be flying up and down. That is the to and fro motion of the particle of the string or particle of the membrane. So this is called as vibratory motion. Here this you are beating the bell, this is oscillatory. Here when you are pulling, the whole gong undergoes to and fro motion in the bell. Same way here pendulum, the whole pendulum go and to and fro motion. So this is oscillation, this is vibratory motion. So now I told one more random motion, that is the animal moving or ant moving. These are all a random motion. We can't describe the path clearly, whether it is oscillatory, whether it is rectilinear or circular, or that is zigzag. That is called as random motion. Now previously, when these devices or wheel is not invented, how the people used to go by walk. Then after the wheel invention only all these cart is made first, then after the cart boats are made, and bicycle is made, train, car, aeroplane, all these are designed after the invention of the wheel. Now in previous before wheel invention, they used to go by walk only, long distances also. After that, early man started two logs keeping on the legs. They will be keeping rolling that log. So heavy things keeping on that rolling. So with that rolling part, they got the idea and they have developed the wheel. Now so many transportive airways, roadways and seaways, transportation vehicles they made after that. Now you have to do one assignment, that is what is the similarities and differences between a moving fan and a moving wheel of a bicycle.